I think my whole family would agree that our experience with this, what this was from the day it started, has become, was and still is part of one of the most defining things in our lives, of things that my daughter, in fact, my youngest daughter would say that if you asked her to this day what was the best thing that's ever happened to you, she said moving to Seattle with us when we were going through this. So our memories here are, it's actually going to be quite bittersweet leaving, assuming that this is my last trip out here. We've been coming, initially it was twice a year, and now once a year for the last maybe 10 years. And we meet the same team, the same doctor, the same PA, same nursing staff. We hug each other. We've emailed each other, and it will be hard to think that I won't be seeing these people again, but that's part of it too, which eventually you're going to go home. We went home after 100 days after transplant, and now maybe this is more of a permanent going home. We were originally scheduled to be transplanted at a transplant unit closer to home. And there, when we were getting closer to selecting a donor or finding a donor, that place, that transplant center, said that they were having a hard time finding a match because I had a different kind of allele attached to my DNA strand, something that they weren't, they said they try to match you a 10 out of 10 on HLAs. There was actually one point where I remembered telling the team, I said, you know, when we moved out here, I did not have any chemotherapy until such time as I was ready for transplant. And we had worked so hard to get me into remission back in Wisconsin. I thought, oh my God, I got to have chemo in order to keep this remission. And they said, no, just don't worry about it. We got this. We've done this a few times. And so I was able to just relax a little bit, throw my life in their hands, and here I am 13 years later.